Hi, King Creator fans. A few days ago, while making an invention, I ended up needing a blowtorch. So I thought, why don't I show my dear subscribers how to make a homemade one? For this, we'll need two lighters, one long and one short. We'll need to dismantle the lighter by removing its screws and other various parts. Once undone, remove the metal stick with the tubes inside. Then remove the metal tube so that we are left with just this part. Next, remove the little plastic covering that it has. To be able to open the compartment containing the supply mechanism, separate the hose from the fuel tank, leaving us only with this piece, of which we'll only need the upper part. Join this last piece to the outlet of the shorter cigarette lighter and replace the metal piece we removed at the beginning. This fish tank motor will go from supplying air to our fish to supplying air to our blowtorch. To make it work, we'll need a square battery, a pair of wires with a snap, and a switch. Once you have all the elements that make up the electrical system, begin to connect the cables. Connect both the black wire from the snap and the black wire from the motor to the switch, and the red wires to each other. Does anyone know which is negative and which is positive? Bring in the battery and connect the clasp, then flip the switch to test that it works. Take the syringe they use to vaccinate you and remove the tip. Have you been vaccinated already? Discard the lid and keep only the sharp part. Bend the needle in the middle using tweezers and be careful not to break it. Once we've made the hand of Captain Hook, proceed to put glue on the bottom and attach it to the fish tank motor. Perfect! Add more glue to the tab protruding from the motor and attach it to the lighter at the height shown on the screen. Do the same with the battery on the opposite side of the cigarette lighter. And to this, add the switch. Get a long bolt and a nut of the same caliber. Screw the nut onto the bolt with a few turns and glue it to the short side of the lighter where the switch is. You'll need a lot of hot glue to keep it in place. We're finished! Honestly, if I saw this thing without knowing what it was, it wouldn't make any sense to me. But to demonstrate its power, let's test it against different materials. For starters, look at the beautiful blue flame. Isn't it enough just to look at it? I believe that in my other life, I was a firebender. Remember to turn on the switch to activate the air output so you can light whatever you want. Ready for the test of fire? First, we'll test it with some solder, which you know is easy to melt. See how the drops of metal drip and fall on the table? Now the real opponent, a Pepsi can. You think you're better than Coca-Cola, huh? Then take this. After a while, the can no longer resisted and gave up. See how our blowtorch punctured it with ease? I hope no prisoner in any jail sees this tutorial and builds it to open their cells. Although now that I think about it, they may not even have access to 80% of the necessary materials. On this channel, we've remained faithful to the best soft drink ever created, Coca-Cola. Tell us in the comment what your favorite soda is. Get out your multi-use tool and choose something with the ability to pierce plastic caps. Insert one of the motors into the hole in the lid and secure it with lots of glue. Repeat the step with the other pair. Take a pair of rubber bands and wrap them twice around the ridged parts of the caps. Next, find a wide wooden stick and glue both motors to one end with super glue. Let's just say these will go around and round and round. I'll let you figure out why. Purchase coated wire from your nearest hardware store. Cut a piece and connect it to the plugs of the two motors. Now it's time for wires with clasp. Connect the red wire to a free plug of one of the motors. Find a clickable switch and connect it to the black wire. I forgot to tell you to buy black wire as well, but another trip to the hardware store won't hurt. After connecting it, put super glue on the base of the switch and glue it well to the wooden stick. We'll do the same with the clasp, so move those little hands. Remove the big battery from a toy and plug it into the clasp. Finally, cut the excess with a saw and test the invention. I know, I said that was the last step of the invention, but it won't do any good if you don't have your mighty paper airplanes. When I was in high school, my friends and I would make several of these and throw them around the classroom at the same time. Good times. Don't think that I've betrayed Coca-Cola. They just didn't have any more at the corner store, and I had to settle for Pepsi. Well, we'll drink it anyway. Since nothing goes to waste here, raise your hands if you like Pepsi. If you did, cover your eyes. You won't want to see this. With a surgeon's precision, slice off both the top and the base of the can with a box cutter. Once we've got only the body of the can, remove the roughness from both ends with a pair of scissors. Then, with the same scissors, cut the can in the middle. Find a tubular candy container and use it to roll the skin of the can. Okay, let's stop with the creepy stuff. Once rolled up, use some of our powerful glue to close the open end, leaving the can with the same tubular shape as the container. We will now make a collaboration between both brands by adding a Coca-Cola cap to our invention. Make a large hole in the center of the lid with a sharp tool. Be patient, as this is an aluminum lid, and let's just say it will take a little more work. Place the Pepsi tube in the Coke cap and secure the collaboration with a glue contract. Once the deal is sealed, move on to making the fuel for our future rocket. For this, we'll need a few matches, not to say the whole box. Use a white sheet of paper as a tablecloth to prepare the powerful recipe that you've already seen in previous videos. In case you don't remember, I'll refresh your memory. Cut a lot of the match heads, stir them so they gain flavor, and empty them into our tube. This wasn't the recipe for smoke balls. Who changed the recipe? Well, with your finger, tap the mixture a few times so that it settles well. Take another Coca-Cola cap, which we'll use to close the tube with the mixture. Using a pointed stick, open a path inside the tube so that we can insert the wick in the next step. As I mentioned before, insert the wick through the hole we just made. Take some aluminum foil and make a little ball that will block any of the contents from leaking out of the tube. Practically, all that's needed is a bit of design. With a black marker, make two lines, one of 8 centimeters horizontally and another of 20 centimeters vertically. Then join them, forming a triangle. Cut out what we just drew with scissors and use the cut piece to replicate it 2 more times. While I do it, why don't we talk for a while? Tell me about your hobbies. What do you guys do in your free time? I'm a big fan of video games. I love the worlds and stories they tell. It fascinates me to analyze how they're created and to be able to be a part of that world. Although I must confess that few people like to play with me because, let's say, I'm a little bit obsessive. Oops, I think I got excited with that talk. Glue the wings to the rocket. It reminds me of a certain spaceship. Where have I seen it before? Without further ado, I present the fabulous phosphorus propulsion rocket. Once the fuse is lit, nothing will stop it. This invention is not for indoor use. Use it only in the open field. In case of impact with a living being, take to hospital and light a candle. Thanks for watching our inventions made out of household items today. Follow my channel if you'd like to learn more about making simple yet incredible inventions. Also, click on the link to see more videos about my amazing inventions. Click on the link to subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any of my videos. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial. Until next time.